Dear students, I welcome you again in this online session on same chapter. In previous session, we have learned pseudomolecular reactions and what are the reasons for pseudo behavior. Now, today we are going to study about methods for determinations order of reactions. Now let us go to the methods to determine order of chemical reaction. There are different methods used to determine order of chemical reaction. First one, integrated rate equation method. Now this method, integrated rate equation methods, we already derive this integrated rate equation for zero, first, second order reactions, and with the help of this equation we find out this value of K, and then and with the help of this value of K judge this order of reactions. Now the integrated rate equation method, the concentration of reactants or products are obtained at different time intervals during the course of reaction experimentally. These concentration data are substituted in the various integrated rate equations of first, second, zero and third order reaction, and value of rate constant K is calculated. The integrated rate equation which gives nearly almost constant value of rate constant K for series of time intervals, means different time intervals, determines the correct overall order of the chemical reaction. The method involves trial of one integrated rate equation after another. Now here this method, this integrated rate equation, with the help of this integrated rate equation, the value of K is obtained, and then we can determine this order of or judge this order of given chemical reactions. Now the second method is graphical method. The advantage of this method over other method is that in one graph both the reaction order and rate constant, both reaction order means N and rate constant means K, can be determined. The integrated rate law expression of different order can be arranged in terms of a equation of a straight line. Now these are this from the integrated rate equations of zero, first, second and third order reactions. With the help of this integrated rate equations, these forms are right in this way. The first is zero order reactions here. Now this, as we know, this integrated rate equation has already derive this integrated rate equation for zero order reaction is K0 is equal to X divided by T, and so this equation write in this way, X is equal to K0 into T, means X is the concentration, K0 is the rate constant or zero order reaction, T is the time. Now with the help of this equation we plot the graph. Now here this equation is similar to the y is equal to mx. Now here the first order reactions, the integrated rate equation for first order reaction is, as we know, k1 is equal to 1 upon t ln a upon a minus x. Now this equation write in this way, ln a minus x is equal to minus k1 into t plus ln a. Now this equation is similar to the y is equal to mx plus c, and with the help of this equation plot the graph. With the help of this from this graph find out this slope and rate constant. Then second order reactions, as we know, the second order reactions are classified in two different cases, case one for equal initial concentrations and case second for unequal initial concentrations. Now as already derived this equation of integrated rate equation of second order reactions, then this equation write in this way, 1 upon a minus x is equal to k2 into t plus 1 upon a. Now this equation is equal to, this equation is similar to this, y is equal to mx plus c. Then second, ln a minus x divided by b minus x is equal to k2 into a minus b into t ln a minus b. A minus b into t minus ln b divided by a for unequal initial concentrations. Now the third order reaction is not included in our syllabus, but directly write here integrated rate equation form, 1 upon a minus x square is equal to twice into k3 into t plus 1 upon a square for equal initial concentrations. Now here means these are these forms of this zero, first, second and third order reaction, different forms. Then with the help of this equation plot the graph. First of all, this plot x means concentration versus time t. The nature of the graph is straight line passing through the origin would be a zero order reactions. Then second, if plot the graph ln a minus x versus time t, the nature of the graph is straight line is obtained. Then this is a slope is equal to minus k1. Now this line is intercept here y-axis, this is the intercept is equal to ln a. Then third, if 1 upon a minus x is plotted against time t and a straight line is obtained, then this is the nature of the graph, straight line, 1 upon a minus x versus time t. Now this is slope is equal to k2, and this intercept is equal to 1 upon a. Now this is intercept on y-axis. Find out this slope, and with the help of this slope, determine this rate constant. Then another graph, if ln a minus x divided by b minus x is plotted against time t, see this ln a minus x, this is concentration term, and versus time t, the nature of the graph is straight line obtained, then slope is equal to, this is k2 into a minus b. Now this line is intercepts on y-axis here. Now this is the ln minus ln b upon a, this is intercept. Now here a and b are these the second order reactions of unequal initial concentrations. Then last, the third order reactions. For third order here, plot the graph 1 upon a minus x bracket square versus time t, the nature of the graph is straight line here, then take this slope, and slope is equal to twice k3. Now this is intercept is equal to 1 upon a square. Then third method, half-life method. This method is also known as fractional change method. This method is used only when the rate law contains only one concentration terms of reactant. In this method, the time required for a reaction is completing a half-life of the reaction is determined at two different initial concentrations. Now the first, for second order reactions, T half is independent of initial concentration of the reactants. Mean that is T half is proportional to 1 upon A, means inversely proportional. Mean that is independent of initial concentrations. For third order reaction, T half is inversely proportional to the square of the initial concentration of the reactants. T half is proportional to 1 upon A square, means square of the initial concentration. As we know this, first order reaction T half is equal to 0.693 divided by K1. In general, we can write for nth order reactions, T half is proportional to 1 upon A raised to N minus 1. When A is the initial concentration of the reactant and N is the order of reaction, small n is the order of reaction. For determining this order of particular chemical reaction, the reaction is followed in two different sets of experiments by taking two different initial concentrations, that is A1 and A2. Now perform the two sets taking two different initial concentrations, that is small A1 and small A2 of the reactants. The corresponding half-life periods T half for concentration 1 and means initial concentration first and T half for the initial concentration second are obtained. Means T half 1 is proportional to the 1 upon A1 raised to N minus 1. T half of second is proportional to the 1 upon A2 raised to N minus 1. Now this is equation A and equation B. See this equation. Means 1 means for T half for 1 and T half for second, means here taking two different initial concentrations. Divide the equation A by B, we get T half of 1 divided by T half of second is equal to A2 divided by A1 in bracket raised to N minus 1. Now here, this equation, taking the logarithm of above equation, we get log of T half of 1 divided by T half of second is equal to, now this N minus 1 into log of A2 divided by A1. Now our aim is find out this order, and hence now this N, calculate this N, take this N here. Therefore N is equal to 1 plus log of T half of 1 minus T half of second divided by log of this A2 minus log of A1. Now this is equation. Now this equation is used. Now this equation is used for calculation of order of reactions. N means order of reactions, half-life period of 1 and half-life period of second. Now this A2 and A1 are the different initial concentrations, and with the help of this equation we find out this order of reactions. Now this another method, last method, is differential methods. This method was first given by the scientist Ventov in 1884. According to the rate law for nth order reaction, the rate of reaction varies as the nth power of concentration of the reactant. So this means the rate of the reaction varies, in changes, as the nth power of concentration of the reactant. For rate of reaction is equal to minus d of concentration of A with dt is equal to k into concentration of A to the power m. Now this is equation number 1. See this equation. Now the experiment is carried out at two different initial concentrations. Say the concentration of A is 1 and another concentration of A second. For equation 1, find out this rate. R1 is equal to minus d of concentration of A of 1 with dt is equal to k into concentration of A 1 to the power n, and R2 is equal to minus d of concentration of A second with dt is equal to k into concentration of A, now this 2 to the power n. Now this is equation number second and third, where R1 and R2 are the rates of reaction at two different concentrations. Taking the log of equation second and third, log R1 is equal to log of d minus d concentration of A1 with dt is equal to log k plus n log of concentration of A1. Log R2 is equal to log of minus d of concentration of A second 2 with dt is equal to log k plus n log concentration of A2. Now this is equation 4 and 5. From equation 4 and 5 we get, now see this n, find out this n, determine this value of n. N is equal to, now this log bracket minus d of concentration of A1 with dt minus log in bracket minus d of concentration of A second with dt divided by this log concentration of A of 1 minus log concentration of A of second here. Now here this log, the value of log R1 means this value, this put here this log R1 minus log R2, this is value of R2 divided by this remaining part as it is, that is log concentration of A of 1 minus log concentration of A of 2. Now this is equation number 6. Now this equation here, this minus d of concentration of A of 1 with dt and minus d concentration of A of 2 with dt are the initial slopes which can be determined by plotting the concentration versus time t curves for two different initial concentrations. Plot the graph, two different initial concentrations, concentration of A1 and concentration of A2. Then order of reaction can be obtained with the help of above equation number 6. Now here means the two curves are obtained, and with the help of these two curves of two different initial concentration, and find out the value of n, and n is the order of reaction. Now then one of these chart is prepared here, comparison of rate laws, zero order, first order and second order. In our syllabus, zero order reaction, first order reaction and second order for two cases, equal and unequal. Now first point is differential rate laws. In a zero order reaction, rate is equal to k0. Then first order reaction, rate is equal to k1 into concentration of A. K1 into concentration of A means this is A minus X, change in concentration. For second order reactions, rate is equal to K2 into concentration of square, A square. For equal initial concentrations, rate is equal to K2 concentration of A into concentration of B. Now here, from this differential rate laws, then determine integrated rate law equation for this zero order reaction is k0 into x divided by t. Now k0 is the velocity constant and rate constant for zero order reaction. X is the concentration, t is the time. Then from this first order reactions, the integrated rate equation is k1 is equal to 2.303 divided by t log a upon a minus x. Now here a is the initial concentration and a minus x is the change in concentration after time t. Then for second order reactions, the equal initial concentrations for the integrated rate law is rate equation is k2 is equal to 1 upon a into t into x upon a minus x. Now here a is the initial concentration, t is the time, x is the decreasing concentration. These are the change in concentration after time t. Now these are the concentration terms. Then for unequal initial concentrations for second order reaction, integrated rate equation is k2 is equal to 2.303 divided by a minus b into t log b into a minus x divided by a into b minus x. Now here for unequal initial concentrations. Now units for k or rate constant, here the zero order reactions mole per liter per second. Now here per second, and for second order reaction liter per mole per second. Now this half life period of zero order reaction is t half is equal to a divided by 2 into k0. Then half life period of first order reaction is t half is equal to 0.693 divided by k1, and half life period of second order reaction is equal to 1 upon k2 into a. That means half life period is inversely proportional to a first power of the initial concentration. Half life period is t half is equal to 1 upon k2 into a. Now this is the all regarding this explanation about this zero first order and second order reaction. Now stop here. Thank you.